My name is Egils, and I'm resident in Lighthouse for the last, well, from the very beginning, really. I helped to paint and decorate even before the opening. And then it's a dangerous thing when you are somewhere at the right place at the right time, then Daddy sees you, and then you end up there for life. So that was my destiny. Actually, it's quite an interesting aspect because, you know, I'm originally from Latvia, which is a small country north east of Europe, with Sweden and Finland, Scandinavia, and Estonia, Latvia, Lithuania. And I had a job at the Swiss embassy, which ended in January 2005. And so when I knew that my job was finishing, I somehow didn't want to stay in Latvia because I used to come to UK every year, and I knew Daddy and Gentie Ben, so I always kept a good connection. And so I had a feeling just to have it some change because Latvia had joined the European Union. And so I bought ticket for beginning of February to come over. And then on 18th of January 2005, Gentie Ben was presenting to Baba this place in Madhuban. And when I heard on the webcast, yes, she was presenting this place in Worthing. They knew it, they just had acquired it. I had like pins and needles, or I don't know in English how you say, like, or little ants running down your spine. So I somehow, and I knew I had this ticket already coming to UK, I somehow had a feeling that I will end up in this place. And so that happened one morning. In a few months after I was in London, one morning Gentie Ben came to me and said, could you come to help for a few months to paint and decorate in Worthing? Because I helped in Oxford many years ago to Nathan. And so Nathan was doing this renovation painting. And so that's how I came and never went back to London, which is actually quite pleased about. So I always like, because Latvia is by the sea. It's a very long coastline. Slightly different sea to the channel, but still beautiful. So yes, and I've been, since then, I've been down here in Worthing, and the journey on this path is always very interesting, exciting, and there is always new things to learn, and some new horizons are always opening. You know, when we are climbing up the mountain, there are, it doesn't just go up, you know, when you think, you know, we are going up, and then sometimes people get disheartened because during going up, there is also places where you have to go down to go, like a valley, to go further up again. So I think that we really have to keep in mind that this journey is never just up, up, up. So there will be things which will take us down to get further up. So that you really have to keep in mind. And it's like an onion layers. There are so many of these layers, so many of these valleys we have to go through to get to the top. And so it's always, I think the life of spirituality, where we start learning something about, you know, especially the knowledge which Baba gives us about the whole world cycle and history and geography. I mean, that gives big peace of mind as a baseline, I think, as Brahmins, you know, no matter what's going on in the world, that point of drama will always make us really peaceful and happy. I mean, at least peaceful, maybe not always happy, but it's something which always keeps us on track, because I know many people who are in New Age, spiritual, religious, they do go really, they worry a lot what's going on in the world, because there are so many things which are happening which are not any under anyone's control. And people are thinking and dreaming about the heaven and the beautiful world, but somehow it's never coming in their reach. But for us, we know that in a bigger picture, at some point of time, we will enter this golden age and gate with deities and butterflies and everything nice and nice food and nice fruits and fresh air and no pollution and no war and no one will bug us and there will be no neighbors and no Brahmins who will be doing something nasty to us or someone else who doing at work, you know. So in this context, I've been myself, and I think every one of us, apart from coming to Murli and just listening, you know, what Baba's direct versions are, we always want to learn and explore more about this whole world and why we are and why the world is the way it is and why my life is the way my life is. And Baba doesn't always explain everything in minute detail. And sometimes Baba even says that you go to the scientists if you want to know more about something about this world. So I think there is lots of things we can explore. And there is a lot of science. I mean, Baba's knowledge is now going really on a level of science proving lots of these things, which maybe 20, 30, 40 years ago, people were thinking we were sort of woohoo, you know, sort of voodoo, and not sort of they were always afraid because something you can't see. Now, things which we can't see are becoming more, we are becoming more and more able to see or have more proof of the aspects of life, which before people, although in deep, sense, these things have been around for a long time. It's just because of now internet and all the means of getting access to information, it's more available. So what I wanted to explore, and it's my personal journey, and I would like to also do some practical things which we can do, because otherwise we can you know, share, and it becomes like a pundit, you know, you can share deep points. And but something which I use myself in my personal life and which anyone can use in anyone's life. And there are three areas in most people's lives, which is one is relationships, another one is prosperity and abundance, and the third one is the health and well-being. And I think anyone, whether you are a Brahmin, non-Brahmin, any human being on this planet, very, very few who will have all three in a very, very good condition level, that you have no problems with your health, nothing, you know, everything is functioning ideally, that you have no issues with abundance and prosperity in your life, that, you know, everything is like in golden age. And relationships, that's one of the biggest. I think the relationship area in this world, whether you are a Brahmin, non-Brahmin, it's completely irrelevant. I think everyone knows that you have someone in your life with whom you have some, you know, disagreements in a diplomatic language. So now, why there are all these things, and health is also a big area. You know, health is another. I think most, especially Brahmins who've been around the whole cycle, we are quite, lots of us have a lots of also body issues, health issues. And so I've been personally on this journey, exploring myself why I've got, you know, certain maybe problems with some people, and you know, I had a little bit, not big health issues, but some issues. So you are thinking about these things and exploring. And so what I've been personally seeing and understanding from my research and practice is that everything is energy. So that's one of the base principles, that everything in this physical world, or even non-physical, everything is made of energy. And whatever in relationships, everything, you know, the matter is form of energy. the feelings, the relationships, the abundance, your health, everything has a frequency. Everything is made of energy. And that's the quantum science is already proving that, you know, we think this chair is solid, that this body is solid. It's actually 99.9999% empty space, energy. If you had a very, very powerful microscope and you would magnify your body, you would actually see that there is nothing. You know, it's mostly made out of energy. And so that's what I think one of the things why people in the past, because there wasn't these findings so much available, because it's so solid, we think it's so solid. Obviously, as you know, coming to Baba teaching about, you know, three worlds and, you know, we souls, the world beyond, sort of we on the basis of faith, we believe in such things. But most people were thinking we are cuckoo. You know, you know, what we are believing, it's something what doesn't exist. But now we can see how these things all exist around us. And so one of the principles which I have been exploring, and I mean, many of you might also have been, you know, onto this journey, but I will just share how I see these things, that there is an aspect that energy follows our thoughts, but our thoughts create energy. Whatever is going on in this big head is creating certain form of energy, certain form of frequency. And the energy follows this thought forms. So that's actually what Albert Einstein's thought was, the quote that energy follows thought. So that's one of the basis of these findings and things which we can apply in our life and explore. And so, how does that translate into our life? Well, everything, if we see everything as energy, then everything around me is actually my creation. And I know these things, when we start going deeper, looking at these three aspects of my life, health, relationships, and prosperity and abundance, and all other areas of life, it's all my creation. It's not easy pill sometimes to swallow, especially if we have lots of health issues, if we have really not nice relationship problems. And I've got lots of Brahmins. I know some ask for help, and I know even some mothers in London, and she has a husband, he's not on this path, and he's drinking, and it's the life is a hell. But we have to realize that everything is created by me. Once you put this aspect that energy follows thought, and whatever is happening in my life is created by me, you are already on the starting line for change. You are already champion. Already, when you accept this thought, because I will tell you, most people blame their circumstances. And I've got a very nice, I just took a few things to read to you, that George Bernard Shaw said, people are always blaming their circumstances for what they are. I don't believe in circumstances. The people who get on in this world are the people who get up and look for the circumstances they want. And if they can't find them, make them. So when we start going into this aspect of understanding that everything what's in my life is my creation, we start changing the circumstances in our life. Because it's the most interesting aspect that out of all the animals of this planet, we are the only animals, because we are all animals, like animals, you know, creatures, physical beings with, you know, arms, and we eat something, so we procreate, have children. Most animals will blend into their environment. If you have a, if it's some worm eating green leaves, it will have a it's green in color, so you can't see it. You know, it sort of goes and jumps onto the leaves. Or zebra, you know, it has these stripes. So every animal, they blend into the environment. We as human beings are the only animals or the only beings on this planet. We don't blend into the environment. We are, you know, very visible. The only difference is that we are the only ones on this planet who can create our environment with our mind, because no one else, most beings on this planet, they live by instincts. They don't have reasoning factors and like as humans. So we are the only ones who can create our environment. So now, again, what is my environment? So when we look at our life, and this is what I wanted a little bit to also like a reflection for everyone. We it's a very, very actually this topic is very deep, very deep. It's a life-changing topic, and if you apply things, you will in 1 year's time, if you do certain things in your life, you will need telescope like a massive telescope to see where you were one today in 1 year's time. If you come back next year, you will not recognize yourself in 1 year's time if you do certain things, because we can change the environment the way we all want. And I've got something on the stage. Some sisters were asking, what's that bicycle? Well, we'll cycle around, so we'll see what we do the what we use the bicycle for. But now, this whole aspect of energy and my life. So if we create the environment, so it means that we have created what's going on in my life, in all areas in my life, my health, my relationships, and my prosperity and abundance. So we all have some issues, some problems. Everyone has something. But now, where do we go next? Most people are just like aeroplanes without the pilot. You know, when this pandemic was going, there was a caricature on internet quite often. I saw people were sending. There was an aeroplane and people sitting, you know, waiting for the flight to take off. And then there is a voice. I am captain of this aeroplane. I'm working from home. But what I want to say is that most people's lives are like this aeroplane without a captain. It's just flying somewhere. And another example I can give is a sheep. If there is a sheep and a sheep has a destination where it needs to go, and you have crew on the sheep, you have captain with a beautiful hat, and everything is set into the ship's computer where it's going. It's going to Mumbai, you know, or wherever. It will most likely, like nearly 99.99 times out of 10,000 times, it will reach the destination. Now, if you take the ship and you take the crew off the ship, you take the captain off the ship, and you start the engines and just let the ship go, you know, most likely the ship will never get even out of the harbor. If it gets out, it will probably end up somewhere in some beach, somewhere as a derelict. So, in this way, I will show you something else, another example. That's why I brought this bicycle. It's a very nice bicycle, by the way. Very nice bicycle. Now, if you stand up on a bicycle, well, you're falling off the bicycle. You're not getting anywhere. The only time when you will be stable on this bicycle, when you move forward. When you move forward, you get balance and you move, you don't fall. But most of our lives, most people's lives are like this standing bicycle, or like the ship which is just floating around the planet without any destination and just ending somewhere, or the aeroplane without the captain, just flying somewhere. Or another example, if you go out of your house and you don't know where you're going, you turn right, you go somewhere, then turn another. You just go somewhere. You have no idea where you're going. Or you go on holidays. You just buy a plane ticket to Delhi and then you fly somewhere else. But you have no idea where really you want to go. You just go here around some other country. Aimless. So that's why one of the things which is most important in life, and that's where I was saying about the starting line that you are a champion. Once you realize that everything in your life is your creation, everything, you are a champion. And when you start thinking about what you really want in life, you become already a successful person. You will be already in the golden age. So that's why this is one of the things which we can explore. And I will show you also some other things, what practically we can do to achieve what we want in life. Because no one wants to be miserable. No one wants to be unhappy. No one wants to be poor. No one wants to have bad relationships. No one. Who wants? But quite often we have things which we don't want. Even if you, with the best wishes, with best intentions, you try, you know, but still you can't get job. I had someone in Delhi, he was asking me for help, couldn't find job for years, has a wife, children. But you have to realize that it's your creation, what's happening in your life. And it's you who has to stand on the start line. Realize that this is what I've created. And now I'm going to start driving, cycling forward. If you're not going forward, you're going backwards. Life is never static. If you're not going forward, you're going backwards. So what's the cause of all of this? And I know we understand lots of things. Baba has taught us we are souls. We are, you know, carrying sanskars, lots of recordings from previous births. Yes, that's true. But there is something else very, very interesting, which maybe that's where sometimes we have to explore. And science is now showing how we as human beings get programmed. You know, like when you buy a new computer, you need software, you need programs. In the same way, when we grow up in this body, we all get programmed. And you get programs which come down the line from your ancestors, whichever family you've been born into. This is miraculous. It's like we have no idea, because when we have an iceberg, iceberg has a little tiny tip above the water. The rest is the invisible, the subconscious stuff, the programs which we all have, which is running our life. That's why you can't find a job. That's why you maybe have issues constantly. You know, constant, it's the same. Like someone maybe has certain things, you know, has difficult husband. You leave husband, get another husband, again, difficult husband. You get 10 husbands, you have all the same thing. You have, you know, you don't like this, I don't like this place. You know, these people around I better go to Australia. You go to Australia, the same people, hello, I'm here waiting for you because it's you are taking yourself. You can't, unless you change what's underneath the iceberg, what's underneath in the subconscious makeup of you. You will always carry and you will always have the same garden or nettles or weeds around you. It depends what's in your subconscious makeup, what's in your programs, what's in your software. And the main thing is not to be disheartened. Not to be disheartened. One thing is sometimes we look at these things, yeah, but what can we do? What can we do? Life is tough. Yes, life is tough, but there are certain things, and that's why I want to explore with you together to show how, apart from and being Brahmin, doing Baba's lifestyle, practicing purity, meditation, you can become superhuman, superwoman, Superman. We can all become like superhumans if we apply certain things apart from just Baba's Muli. If you just sit and meditate and wish for a golden age, you could be 100 years down the line, the same sanskars you will have. The programming, we have to reprogram the things you don't want in life. And that's one of the things which most people have the biggest mistake. That we think what we don't want. I don't want this. I don't want to be poor. I don't want to have bad relationships. But remember the principle that energy follows thought. Whatever you think follows you. That's why the main principle which I would suggest you write with big writing somewhere at home. Think what you want, not what you don't want. That's one of the key principles. Now, so this programming, even your tastes, you think that you like something to eat. You think it's you who like this taste. It's your grandmother, grandfather, 700, 800, 1,000 years ago. They liked some certain foods. These things go down the line because it's not just the soul which carries from one birth to another. It's the genetic, the memory, the programs, the software. And it's not something which is consciously someone is putting, oh, you like this turmeric sabjis or something, it just gets passed down the line. Fee was sometimes laughing because I like some pickled cucumbers. And the pickled cucumbers, they, quite common in Latvia where I was born. So I said, yes, it's my ancestry passed down the line. I like these pickled cucumbers. It's like a software somewhere from inside. So now this programming, I will give you a very interesting example. Everyone is driving a car. When you started learning, I think there was a time when I remember when I hadn't driven a car. I had a motor moped when I was a little teenager. But then, I was 15, or my dad said, "Okay, let's go. You try to drive." So I sit in, and you start sweating. Okay, it was somewhere in a closed area, just a little bit. Even you don't know how to put the clutch in this. And now, when you start learning to drive, you have to be on the road. Traffic lights, and then they, when you go up the hill, there is traffic lights, and you have to do this and the handbrake, and then you need to look around and car. So it's very, very frightening because you don't have the program of driving. Now, once you learn to drive after 5 years, 10 years, you can drive in Bombay singing. Thinking about Baba or your daughter or whatever, you don't even you I was coming a month ago. I was coming from Oxford, bringing someone was coming here, and I was changing lanes. They were like merging with motorway, big trucks coming. I was just chatting with this sister, about all these sort of life and icebergs and all these bicycles. I was not, because I've got the program, the software inside, which is actually running this whole thing. That's why this is one of the key things we really need to understand, that the most of our life is run by our subconscious makeup. We consciously think. You think a lot of things, but always something else happens. Something else always happens. Unless you change this mechanism inside. And it's possible. It's possible to change this mechanism inside. So this is the most marvelous thing which we can do in our life. And one of the things which is the key aspect for changing these programs, and you don't need to dig and think what programs. We have so much stuff there, so much. We've been around the cycle. We have so much baggage inside, and we don't need to think what's there. But if you want to improve your life, we need to think what we really want in our life. And that's why one of the things which is a very, very important exercise is to sit down and just think about your life and write it down. To write down just how your all these areas in life are. How are your relationships? How your relationships were when you were a child? You see, we are all affected by so many things. And most of these things happened when we were children. But these things are affecting us even now. Even if you are 90 or 100, unless you change those things which happened and were recorded as, because children get programmed, and that's been now quite proven, that we get this programming process taking place mainly when we grow up until age 7, 8. So whatever happened in your life, whatever your mom was thinking, whatever your people around you, wherever the society, you were all programmed how to live this life. And we all have different, most people, ancestors, very good, probably good people, nothing wrong, but there has been tough times. It's Copper Age, Iron Age, and people have been thinking, poor times, that money doesn't grow on trees. You go when you are as a child, you go to some shops and you have big dreams. You want this, and mom said, don't dream. Because we have no money, don't dream. We don't dream. We stop because it's been recorded. Don't do these things. Because as a child, you are completely open. You're open as a leaf. Now, when we grow up, everything is in place. And you are just like this aeroplane, just flying around according to what's put inside you. But there are things we can do to change, and to be aware of these things is already the starting line. So that's why this first exercise to actually physically write down everything you think about your life, how your prosperity abundance is, how your relationships are, how your health is, because all these things are linked to your subconscious. Sometimes we take karma, we just say, oh, it's karmic account. It's a very not a very correct way of understanding karma. Quite often we say it's karmic, some bad relationships, it's karmic account. This that I have can't find job, or I have not enough abundance, it's karmic account. I would say karmic account is ignorance, but not what's actually happening in our life. Once we start, because we can change anything we want in life, anything. We don't have the flip chart here, but we all of us have abilities, miraculous abilities, miraculous, health-wise, prosperity-wise, relationship-wise. We have all abilities and possibilities which we have not even dreamt in our wildest dreams. If you picture like a big square, what we have created in our consciousness, and it's many of these things are not consciously, it's not that we did it like that, but whichever way it happened and how it happened, but out of these all amazing abilities which we all have, we are all like in a small box of self-beliefs, what these subconscious beliefs we have, and you will never go beyond what you believe you can do. Only when you start taking these things away and expanding your belief systems and taking all your limited beliefs away, you will see how the grass will start growing in front of your eyes. You will start walking on rope between two mountains, and it will look like as if it's magic, as if some kind of rabbit coming out of the hat. If you don't understand the principle how it's happening, it's magic. But actually, nothing of this is magic if you understand that everything is energy and energy follows thought. So that's why, would you like to spend maybe, I don't know, 5, 6, 7 minutes. It's just like a little exploration. You can do it also later at home, but sometimes it's good when we do such session about such topic to do it on the spot. But there will be even better things will follow after that. So maybe before we do that, I always like to do some icebreaking or energy boosting. We do for 1 minute little raising the energy of a little bit of dancing. No, Bhavesh likes dancing. So we, and it's nice song from South America. So if we put for 1 minute, and then after the 1 minute we move a little bit, then I'll give this piece of paper, and each of us can think about just honestly, you write down how are your relationships, how are your health, how is your health, how is your prosperity and abundance. Yes, how is it now? You can, if there is something what happened or something comes in memory, you know, some people, you know, we say we have poor memory. But people remember things happened, you know, 32 years, one day, and at 5 o'clock, 22, on that coach, something happened. You remember things from, you know, 50 years ago. Memory, all these aspects, very, very fascinating. Fascinating. There is no such thing as poor memory. There is no such thing. We all have excellent memory. You can, if you learn, you can memorize Bible or Murli's books of Murli. You can memorize. If you do some certain practices, we have only weak. If you don't exercise, you don't have muscles. The same is like a memory. You don't have poor memory. It's just a weak. Weak or strong. But no one has bad memory. You know when people say you have bad memory, I have bad memory. Again, you have to be very, very careful how you speak, how you verbalize things in your life. You really have to be careful because you program yourself, you curse yourself. You know, when people say, you know, all kinds of expressions in a negative way about life, even speaking about something happened in news or outside, your subconscious has no clue what you are talking about. It takes it as a command. That's why it's once we explore this, we will see how and what exactly we can do to change this whole wheel, that we will be flying like eagles in the sky. You will be enjoying your life really immensely. Life is for enjoying. Health. There is no reason to be unhealthy. No reason. There is no thing as karmic account. The body is a miraculous system. If we understood the electric system of our bodies in comparison to some electric system of any best, most complex computer on this planet, they are like baby's toys. The way these bodies are operating, it's just, we don't think about these aspects. We have blood flowing around our body hundreds of miles every 33, 45 seconds. The blood circulates around this body, bringing the nutrients to the body and disposing the waste at the same time. It's a miraculous way the body is operating. We have no clue. But the thing is, the mind is the most miraculous thing, which is affecting a lot of things, how this apparatus is functioning. And that's why once you start implementing these aspects of what you want in life, you will see how things will be opening. You know, there is this experiment, Masaru Emoto. Remember this Japanese who did water crystals? He would take photos. He did experiment with rice. He put rice in three containers. One rice, he said, "I hate you." One rice, he said, "I love you." And the third one, he ignored. The one was the one you hate was going bad after 1 month. The one he was ignoring was completely rotting. And the one he was giving love to, it was a pleasant smell fermenting, making this some Japanese thing with this rice. So it just shows how much our consciousness is affecting this whole world. That's why, you know, sending good wishes, it's not some kind of voodoo imagination. All these things are really powerful. And the most powerful is when we are in a very deep, relaxed state. Because most human beings, the brain waves of most human beings, in American Indian traditions, they call adult humans as walking dead, because the brain frequency is so fast, you have no ability to influence anything in this metaphysical world, and everything is energy. Nothing is physical, nothing. Even this chair, the bicycle, everything is metaphysical. And so when we relax, and that's where the meditation, the magic of meditation comes in. Once you deeply relax and start thinking about what you want in life, that's when the magic will start unfolding. You will see what happens in your life with this neighbor who was nasty, or a Brahmin, someone who was really nasty to you. At jobs, you will see magical things happen. If you do, that's one of the things. Most people want just magic wand and something, you know, not to do. But if you do it, that's the, I know we have lots of people who want some help. I said, you have to commit. You have to commit, because I cannot change something for you. The self-image which we all carry inside. See, we are all sort of smiling and, you know, in front of the mirror, in front of people, we all have some one image. But actually, we all have inside another image, which has been, again, linked to these software points, these automated things which are inside. We have the image. That image is the most, that's how the world sees us. Not the way you brush your hair and, you know, try to smile. So when you change that inside image, you will see that's when the magical things, when in relationships. Your life is heaven. Heaven on earth now, not in golden age. Golden age can only happen when we make the golden age in my life, in my head. Otherwise, most human beings are trapped like prisoners in their heads. You know, if we had brains like slugs, would be no problems. If you no problems, you just eat something and go to bed, you know, some procreation takes place. But because we have these big brains, this big thinking, everyone is you know, depression, mental illness, because there is so much activity happening and there is no goals, there is no direction where you are going. When you have no direction, it's like this ship, it just ends as derelict somewhere. People are caught like prisoners in their own bodies, and including Brahmins. That's why, you know, we also have problems. If we just came and put badge on and everything is nice, you know, from day one you come, Baba gives me light and everything becomes a golden age around my life. But it doesn't happen that way. I know for myself. I've been now 16 years living here, full time, surrendered. Still have some things with some Brahmins sometimes. There are still things happening. Still something with the body, because there is the recordings, the programs, the software inside me. It doesn't matter whether you live in Madhuban or you live here or Leicester or London. That's another thing which you really have to understand, that environment has no impact whatsoever what's happening in your life. You know, when this quote by George Bernard Shaw, people think, oh, because of this, because of that. Now, for instance, we have problem with this gas and electricity, the war. Everyone is talking about how we will survive the gas prices. So you see, you already attract in your life a trouble. You already attract by thinking about what you don't want. People are ice skating in somewhere in desert in Dubai, ice skating. You know, when we say that it's the environment, it does not make any difference whether you are from Indian background, African background, whether you are a Mataji or you are a young Kumari or a brother or a female or a man. It does not make difference. The difference happens here. The difference happens here, not on external. But if you want to be a victim, which most people are like victims, you think everything is happening outside you, but you will never make any consequence of whatsoever in this world if you think from outside in. If you think that things are affecting from outside and that's why my life is like this, you will never make any consequence whatsoever. The only way, as Brahmins, you can make any impact on this planet, if you go in and live from inside out, you affect the economy, you affect the neighbors, you affect the, you know, the relationships in your job. You create, you have the, that's what we all have in our arms, in our hands. The ability to create the energy we want, the environment, the atmosphere, it's in our hands, it's in our mind. The change is, you know, change yourself. We always have this big slogan, when I change, the world changes. That's what it is. When I change, the world changes. But we sometimes don't understand that there is so much underneath. There is so much baggage inside. It's not just black Om Shanti badge and white kurta pajamas and I've changed. That's not the change. It's good, white clothes, yes, because you are more aware of cleanliness and like this, but it's what's happening in when the inside starts getting cleansed and clean. So that I can see that time is flying fast. So maybe we do half a minute and then maybe 5 minutes we write this about what you see about your life now, and then we'll see the most magical thing is to come. The most magical. That's why I'm really so excited, because you will fly. When you go back tomorrow, you have no clue. Your bus will be going like airplane. So Pete. So basically, if you just spend 5 minutes just reflecting how your life is, how it is, just the reality of your life in your relationships. As I say, you can explore maybe later tonight if you want, you can a bit more, but just in short, just like analysis of how your prosperity, relationships, and health is right now. No, this is for you. This it's personally for you. You will see why we need to get this done. As I say, you can write just a few points now, but you can write later on a bit more for yourself.
Oh, my pen is just about out. Does that mean not to work?
Marcia or Mark, do you mind to switch off for half an hour? It just disturbs actually. It's quite
loud.
It goes through quite some of yeah, it's sort of.
Those of you that know, Agil swims in the channel in the mornings.
I tell you in the morning.
Come rain or shine, hot or cold, he's in there.
Yes, everyone. Is he serious, by the way?
He swims.
It's
true. Yeah, he swims.
Every
swim.
Day.
In the water.
Yeah, even when it's freezing cold, he'll swim.
So, regarding this exercise, there is a aspect when I was mentioning about the aeroplane or a ship. All these gadgets, they have the mechanism built inside that it will navigate where the course is set. Same the aeroplane, if it's flying from London to Paris and there is some big waves, winds, and it goes off the course, this mechanism of, I think it's called cybernetics, it takes the plane back on course. Exactly in the same way, whatever we set as our goal will take us there. And that's the most interesting thing, is that you don't need to think how you will get there. So that's why the second part of this exercise is to write how you would like to see your health, your relationships, and your prosperity and abundance. And this is another very interesting aspect which Baba is teaching us, that we all have the soul deep inside is completely pure, like a pure diamond. And in another way, we can say that at the very center of our consciousness, right there, at the very center of our consciousness, is where the perfection lies. And God did not create a creation to be defective. You know, when we have our life with problems around, He did not create us to be like this. And when we start going for these dreams and things we want in life, then this inbuilt mechanism, it's crying. It's sort of wanting us to go for these dreams because it will do everything to take us there. That's why you can only go forward with a cycle if you cycle and go forward. Otherwise, you are falling off and there is no balance. That's why it's very, very important to know where you are going. And even more than that, to keep your main dreams in your life as something written down in your pocket. You know, Baba is also teaching, you know, think about your aim and objective, Lakshmi and Narayan. But this is in the same way, whatever you think in life you want, it will come your way if you think about it. Just the same as the things you don't want come in abundance in your life. It's like the boomerang. Whatever you throw, it comes back to you. So that's why you have to be careful what you are actually speaking, what you are thinking in life. You know, karma is not just doing wrong things. It's the thinking which creates the vibration. And this vibration, the frequency, that's what's making the things to happen. You know, there was this film, The Secret. People think it's the law of attraction. It's actually the law of frequency. What's going on in our heads? That's why things of relaxation, and maybe we can do it for the next part, because that's one of the main things. One thing is we understand, yes, okay, we have a problem in life. How do you get out of this situation I have in life? And sometimes we just float along the whole life, struggling. But it doesn't have to be that way. And everything is in our hands. And so one of the things is relaxation. Relaxation, which in meditation, that's why meditation, we all practice meditation, but actually relaxation, not even, you know, it will also add to your meditation practice. But just relaxation is very, very crucial to be able to change anything, to create the right frequency in your brain, in your mind, which will create the things you want in your life. It's like soil, whatever you plant in the soil. If you plant nice tomato seeds, you get beautiful tomatoes coming out. If you plant some deadly nightshades next to it, it will produce deadly nightshades. But the human mind is even more fertile than the land. So that's why whatever seeds, whatever thoughts you plant, what you think, that's where the conscious mind we can utilize. That's the only thing. And that's where we all have to make the effort. If you don't put any work into this, you cannot expect any results. And so, but I think everyone wants to have good results. No one wants to suffer. No one wants to be a victim. No one wants to be poor. No one wants to be having some unpleasant relationships with people. No one wants to be sick. Who wants to be sick? Although health, there is another aspect, that's another whole topic about health and well-being. But we can't touch, that's another topic all in total. But mental aspect will change a lot of things if you start doing these things, if you start thinking about things you want in life. And there are no boundaries, there are no restrictions of what you want to think. Actually, you have to think so beyond what you normally would think. You see, when I was mentioning about this aeroplane and no captain, most people on this planet don't think. Most people don't think, including us as Brahmins. We can live life not thinking, because mental activity, what's happening, just some thinking in head going on, it does not mean you are thinking. Actually, it's around only 2% of people who really think. 3% think they think, and 95% would rather die than think. Because if you observe, and that's another thing you can do for yourself and people around you, if you would think, you would never say certain things, what you are sometimes saying. The same other people, you know, people around you at jobs, if you observe what they are saying, how they are saying, you can see they are not thinking. If they were thinking, they would not be saying these things. The same about doing, what I'm doing in life. If you were thinking, you would not do certain things in your life. And the same, your husband, your children, your boss, they would not do certain things if they were thinking. It's very good to remember, remind yourself to think. Because if you are thinking, you will be responding. You will never be reacting. You know, when you get these relationships, something button is pressed, bang, another button goes back. It's like a missiles. You are on autopilot, just as a victim. You are not thinking. You think you are thinking. You're not thinking. When you are doing something, saying something, if you... And I've been now practicing this quite a lot to remind yourself about these things. And the most marvelous thing is that we can reprogram our subconscious mind. You can reprogram. You put the programs what you want. And in the same way, like, as I said, you go to Australia and the same friends will wait for you saying I'm here, and the same scenarios will be playing out. In the same way, if you reprogram yourself what you want, you will be amazed how things will be playing out. And there are certain things we can practice, like, for instance, an affirmation, I'm always at the right place at the right time. I say the right thing at the right time in the best possible way. Accidents, it's a difference of half a fraction of a second where you get crushed and maybe you lose your leg for life. But if you are at the right place at the right time, you will never get that half the fraction of a second which can damage yourself, your life. But it's inbuilt mechanism in your subconsciousness. It will be doing like you drive the car without thinking, because there is a program how to drive. You don't need to think. It's happening like on autopilot, because it's a program there. The same what you want in life will be like automated program happening. You will be amazed. It will be like magic, like rabbit coming out of the box, and people will be wondering how that's happening. But you create. We are the creators. We are the creators. Baba did not create us just to be subjects and, you know, to be victims. to be suffering. He did not do that. He wants us to be in the golden age, kings and queens, emperors and empresses, deities, happy, abundant, healthy, beautiful relationships, harmony. But that all starts here. It all starts there all the time. Whatever is your image in yourself, that's what will be playing out in your life. So we can talk like this a lot, but I think let's do this. I had a few meditations to give you as a sample, but relaxation is one of the main things, because when you are really, really relaxed, how much time do we need to finish? 6:30? Because I would love to. One of the this is I think 14 minutes, which is like a sample how you can reprogram yourself to relax. Because once you are relaxed and your brain waves frequency comes to alpha state frequency, that's when you can start doing magical things. You can do magic from people's view who don't understand what's happening. But if you understand everything is energy, you can change. I have a friend who is very advanced in this. He, for instance, there was some friend of his, a farmer, and he called in some shop to his alpha fields, alpha crop fields, to put the fertilizer on, alpha for his livestock. The man who came took the wrong chemical. He took the Roundup, which kills everything. So he sprayed all the fields with this Roundup. Everything was dead. Actually, all the shootings which were coming out, they were dead. So this farmer called my friend and said, I've got this problem. Is there anything you can do? And my friend, he said, well, don't plow the fields yet. Wait for a few days. So the next thing he only heard back from him, I think a month later, when this farmer was in his class, where he was sharing things. What happened? He transformed, because everything is energy, frequency. The alpha, the fertilizer is a frequency. The Roundup chemical is a frequency. You can transform, if you're in a certain specific state of mind, you can transform the frequencies, you can transform the energies. So he transformed the Roundup, which killed all everything, into the most beneficial fertilizer. He had the best crop that year, and yet there was not a single alpha seedling which had, it was all like dead. And my friend said he if he knew that everything was completely dead, he would not even have tried. But because he did not know, and that's one of the things, don't ever think that you can't do something. There will be millions of people who will tell you not to do certain things because most people don't think, and they are in this small box in their self-beliefs that they cannot do. We can do miraculous things, and I think that's how Golden Age will come about. When Brahmins take off the lids from their minds, just take off the lid. You are a miraculously powerful being. We can do so many things. We can change this whole world into Golden Age, just like the Roundup. You can do so many things, so many things. Okay, so I'll finish maybe with this, and then if you play practical. Mental pictures, we start with that, and then after that you can live the life you want to live. Yeah, so we'll have a like 25 minutes meditation. The first one, the relaxation, is just an example. You can create your own, but and it's not like meditation what normally used to, but relaxation is very, very important to achieve something inside.
Om Shanti. Your movie is your life. Relax and become the superstar in your movie, in your life. You can begin living the life you really want to live. Nothing is an accident. No one can even guess of what you are capable of doing. There is something wonderful about you. There is something marvelous about you. There is abundance of energy everywhere at all times. Do you want to be a star in your life or just a supporting player or just a walk-on cast? You can change your image and you will change your world. You will only be free when you are you. Do you want to be a star in your life or just a supporting player or just a walk-on cast? You can change your image and you will change your world. I'm supremely pure. I am tidy and clean. I have enough time to do everything I need and choose to do and do it well with time to spare. I give thanks for understanding my life's purposes. I have knowledge and ability to fulfill them. I attract to me people, events, and energy to enhance prosperity and fun. I deserve prosperity and fun. Live the life you want to live. Write your own script. Live the life you want to live. Write your own script of your life.